Well, online and on campus, free speech is imperiled in the name of tolerance. A majority of college students now say that protecting diversity is more important than free speech, as if they're mutually exclusive. On Twitter, YouTube, and Facebook, of course, accounts are routinely banned and opinions suppressed in the name of fighting hate, which is never precisely defined, but you know what they mean. The movement comes mostly from the left, but many traditional, some of them anyway, traditional liberals are upset about it. Nadine Strossen is a former president of the ACLU, and she just released a brand new book called Hate, Why We Should Resist It with Free Speech, Not Censorship. Nadine Strossen joins us tonight. Nadine, thanks for coming on.
My pleasure.
First, a confession. You're the kind of liberal I used to make fun of, and now I wish there were more people like you on the left. There seem to be very few. Why the change? Why are you one of the only people on the left saying, wait, hold on, free speech is more important than anything else?
Well, I'm not going to demonize the left, Tucker, because I completely agree with the sentiment expressed by former journalist, I mean, sadly, who died several years ago, Nat Hentoff, whose book title said it all, Freedom of Speech for Me, but Not for Thee, How the Left
exactly.
and Right Relentlessly Censor Each Other. So a pause
Nat Hentoff, hold on. Nat Hentoff was a wonderful man. And
yes.
I wouldn't say toward the end of his life he was much of a liberal. He was a pro-life activist.
Well,
so,
you know,
if that's the liberal you're citing,
you know,
I'm okay with it.
Some of us are defending individual liberties, and that's the most important value, right?
Amen.
And
I agree.
One of the important messages of my book is that all of us, regardless of where we fall on the political spectrum, have a crucial stake in defending the same robust freedom of speech that the U.S. Supreme Court, interestingly, despite its ideological diversity, unanimously supports in the Supreme Court's most recent decision on so-called hate speech last summer.
Yes.
All of the justices struck down a federal statute that prohibited the use of so-called disparaging or demeaning terms as subject to trademark protection. So they upheld the right, interestingly enough, of an Asian American rock band to choose the name The Slants. Of course that's a disparaging term, but the Simon Tam and the other Asian American rock band members chose that not to denigrate their own ethnic origin, but for exactly the opposite reason, to celebrate their dignity and to empower themselves and show their pride. And that illustrates, Tucker, the problem with handing over to government the power to pick and choose which particular words are going to be ruled out of bounds. You have to look at the context.
Right.
You have to take, you know, all of us have different subjective perceptions, and we have to make these decisions for ourselves and not turn them over to the government.
Well, I agree completely. And the reason that right really is enshrined in modern law is because of the ACLU and the Brandenburg case in 1967 and a bunch of other free speech cases that the ACLU, which you ran for years, brought to the high court. But the main threats to speech now exist not from government, but from big technology companies, particularly from Google and Facebook and Twitter. They're the conduit through which all information flows. They control speech, and they're squelching it, and the ACLU is saying nothing, and I don't know why.
Well, let me tell you, there is a big legal problem here in terms of remedies for what clearly are restrictions on speech. And by the way, I disagree with you that the ACLU has not spoken up. But first, most people do not understand that the First Amendment free speech guarantee only applies to government, to the public sector. So you have First Amendment rights with respect to Facebook and the other private tech companies.
Yes,
however,
but hold
you
on.
Can bring pressure on them. And Tucker, the ACLU, along with a large coalition of other civil rights and civil liberties organizations, have been complaining to Facebook for years about how they are wielding their power to take down hate speech. We've complained that they have not done it in a way that is supportive of equal rights and civil rights.
I respectfully disagree with you. I think the ACLU has stood back. No, it's spending all its time defending illegal aliens, whereas everybody in the world is
I'm
seeing
so
his
sorry.
Or her free speech
Let me
rights.
Tell you that some of us can defend all fundamental freedoms for all people.
But the emphasis on speech has been absent at the ACLU.
Well,
and I think
tell that to the people who are criticizing the ACLU and lobbying us to change our position, which we have not, because we defended the free speech rights of the alt-right demonstrators in Charlottesville. That is a decision that I stand by and that my ACLU colleagues stand by, in part.
No, that's not true. Your ACLU colleagues do not stand by.
I'm here
to tell you how much I respect your views, but you're not being honest there. Mutiny in the ACLU
and a lot of the employees said we're not doing this anymore. And discussion within the ACLU, Tucker. But you know what? We have not seen what we saw during the Skokie case in the late 1970s that raised exactly the same issue when the ACLU came to the defense of a group of neo-Nazis to demonstrate in a town with a large number of Holocaust survivors and other Jews.
No, I remember.
We then lost 15% of our members nationwide, and that has not happened now. Of course, there are people that are arguing that we should not continue to take those cases, but the leadership has not diverted from that, in part for this reason.
I'm torn because...
Tucker,
okay,
man,
we're almost out of time.
You yourself said that we don't have to choose between diversity and equality on the one hand and free speech on the other hand. And I couldn't agree with you more. These are mutually reinforcing, and all of us who care about racial justice and other equality causes have the biggest stake in defending robust freedom
you
of speech.
You filibustered me, and I've let you do it
because I
think you're an important voice for free speech. No, I do think that. But I think you're wrong on some of those details, but we're going to have to talk about it.
Have me back.
In some other forum. Okay, thank you, Nadine.